progress in your code.org dashboard. So you can see here I'm signed into code.org right now, and I know this because it says my name up there and I see that it's my dashboard. Sometimes code.org has some special events like the Hour of Code. This is National Computer Science Education Week, so that's displayed there. So sometimes you have to scroll down a little bit, and the area I'm going to focus on today in this video is classroom sections. So I actually have a lot of classroom sections here, but the one I'm going to look at particularly is this sample class. So to view student progress and their data as they progress through the online activities, if you click on the section name, so in this case sample class, that'll take me to where I can see the progress of all the students that are in the class. So you can see that this section has three students in it, and of the three students, only one has completed some of the activities. And the reason why I know that is because as I look across here, I can see that this student has completed some of the activities in lessons 2, 3, and 4. Now I might be interested to see what has been accomplished there. So if I click on the number, it'll expand and I can see each of the activities within those lessons that have been completed. And then I can actually dive even further, and if I click on one of the activities, so here number 2, it will actually show me what the student has answered. So I can see the answer from that student specifically, which can help me understand the student's thinking as I work through it. And it even tells me like when that was done. And I can do that for any lesson in here and see how the students are progressing through. So that's kind of just a quick way to check and see what the students are doing. Some of the things that I particularly look for is if there's an activity that's been skipped. Sometimes that means that the student maybe didn't understand, and we can go back and work with them to finish it. And then another thing to kind of keep an eye out for are these lightly shaded green, the ones that are shaded light green, because that means that they completed the activity correctly, sort of, but used too many blocks to do it. So there's just a more efficient way. So that's another way that you can go back and kind of check in on the progress and see if the students are really understanding the coding concept. So that's a good way to check on student progress for the online activities. Thank you so much for watching.